this point, that's something we're getting closed sessions about, but we haven't had any hard offers on it yet. So it could be a long time. And just to maintain the boiler, if we have to, that's going to take 3 to 4 full-time employees, plus with any boiler repairs, I'm conservatively figuring $80,000 to $100,000 in that first year just to maintain the boiler, without worrying about extra police protection, boarding up windows, mowing the grass, maintenance of the grounds, just to keep it minimal and trying to keep vandalism down. We're going to have a graffiti problem and other things like that too. Yes, again.
How many acres are involved in the city?
No clue. Do you have any clue on that, Connie?
The total acreage? Uh-huh. The whole thing is 287 or
257
or something like that.
287,
I think.
Are there any ideas thrown around at all?
What I don't know what we can, Josh, we probably can't talk about that too much. There are some ideas. And a lot of it includes the school board, and we're trying to do the best we can for them. We don't even know if their levy's going to pass yet. So
yeah.
I think it's premature to do this before at least we find out what happens April 4th. Or 5th, I'm sorry, 5th.
Charlie. Okay. You know, one of my big concerns, Vince, I mean, you've given us all the reasons why we shouldn't take it. We cannot allow that property out there to become a derelict property to another developer. It's in our city. Ultimately, we're going to be responsible for it. We have to take care of it. So I think we have to be responsible on how that property is going to be distributed. And, you know, who's going to be in charge of it? If we can help other government subsections, we should be able to do that.
So there is, but we can't do that in open meeting, is what I'm saying.
What?
We're going to have to do this in closed meetings every time, is all I'm asking. Why can't we have it in the open in front of everybody and have these discussions?
We are.
Have bids. Have people come in and present things to us that they'd like to do.
Well, bids and things like that, you know, have to be closed and open. And we have to decide how it's going to be distributed.
It's our fault.
And everything else.
It's
That's
our
right.
fault. It's not their fault.
And we need to do that.
We don't have to have closed sessions.
But if we don't take it over, the state's going to throw it up for bid, and anybody's going to be able to buy it, and we have zero control over it. And they get into that place and find out it's going to cost them millions or billions of dollars that it's going to take.
$30 million probably.
They walk away from it. We've got a derelict set of property out here that we can't do anything with. At least we have to talk to the state. I agree with you 100%. But if we can get any kind of help, and we want a lot of help from them.
We're not going to get a lot of help.
Well, we don't know that.
I'll give you the names and numbers.
Well, I've dealt with the state, too. I've dealt with them, too, and I understand how they work. It all comes down to appropriations, and that's a year-to-year thing. But the idea is that we still have to work with them. It's their property now. We have to work with them. I just don't want it to become a derelict property out there.
Neither do I.
Because then we will have lots of police issues and things along that line, if that just is allowed to deteriorate.
But are you willing to roll a $30 million dice on it without talking to engineers, without talking to the Office of Administration?
I would almost be afraid not to roll that dice. Even more so.
Okay. Well, that's why we need the discussion.
But we can distribute that property out. It's not like we have to take it over and keep it. We can distribute that property
the first year's
the way
cost
we decided to do it.
$100,000 minimum.
Is what?
The first year is going to cost us $100,000 minimum.
Why is that?
Just to take care of the boiler and the maintenance.
The boiler doesn't have to run.
Once it stops, you better talk to a maintenance person about that and somebody knows what they're talking about. We cannot.
If you've got buildings you're going to shut out and you shut the boilers off of them, and you, if you're going to got buildings you're going to keep, you either drain them or you put a building, a boiler in that building just to take care of it.
Wouldn't you be much happier hearing that from a maintenance person instead of hearing that secondhand
in front of everybody? I think we know that already, that if we're not going to maintain the building, we don't need to be pumping water to it all the time. We're dealing with the state. Nobody can explain why the state keeps a boiler that old running for that long anyway, when they're not using it.
I think when
you're talking about engineers, we do have an engineering and a developer that is looking at that.
But they want us to pay for it.
But they're going to give us recommendations.
I think we should go out for bid on that. It's the city's money. It's the citizens' money. It's not our money. We're supposed to make decisions like a big decision is buying a fire truck, things like that. We're not supposed to make $30 million decisions without some feedback from the people of the city. That's my opinion. I could be wrong, but they're here tonight, and I think there'll be some more.
And we do have a commitment from the state. I think we have better commitments from the state than what is. Can you allude on what you have talked to with the state about what they've committed?
Okay. This isn't something that we've just, blown off. I mean, we've there's been a lot of work that's gone into this whole thing. We've talked about this for a long time. The last probably, yeah, in the last probably 6 months, this has probably consumed 80% of my time working with the state on this particular property. We have visited with the state. Like Vince says, it does get frustrating at times, but it's frustrating dealing on anything that doesn't just click right along. We've dealt with economic development on this money. What they told me last week was that they had the money. The money's there on the application that I was sent. It says there's a deadline. There's also a limit on what you can get. They told me not to pay any attention to the deadline and not to pay attention to the limit, to write down what we thought we would need money-wise and go ahead and submit that. Well, before we submit that, we have an engineering firm. We had an out there last Friday working on our behalf was an engineer, two engineers, civil and structural, an architect, and my mind just went blank, somebody else. But anyway, they were out there last week looking at that to give us a report back. Yes, the state did want us to make a decision by the end of this month. I contacted them today, and they said that we could have until the 5th of April, then they were going to look at doing something else. If we're going to have, I tend to agree with Mr. Guthrie, if we're going to have buildings somewhere that we're going to need to do something with, we might as well have it all together where we can control it. That's a lot of property. True, is it expense? Yes. Are those buildings empty now? Yes, they're empty now. Some of those buildings have been empty for 6 or 7 years, and it's no different in being empty now than it has been. I mean, they've sat there all this time. So the school district is utilizing, Dr. Mayer and I have been to Jeff City. We have met with the Office of Administration. We've had several meetings with them. I've met with the senator on numerous occasions. And, you know, trying to get all this put together, which is what the council instructed me to do. So that's what I've been, that's what I've worked on, is to get all this put together. So it's not like we're doing a fly-by-night thing here. And I know that's not what Mr. Letterby means, but I understand he's very passionate about this. And I think we all are. You know, we're all trying to do our due diligence. That's why we have these people that are checking things and have people that are looking at things. So we aren't doing this just on a whim. It's not, there's no whim involved here. Could there be a lot of expense out there? Yes, there could. Could there be a lot of expense out there if another developer gets it, takes the cream and leaks the rest and walks off? Yes. If another developer gets it, do I believe that they have the interest of the school district in their sights? No, I don't. We've heard that too many times, that if someone else gets it, they don't want the school there because that will be something that will be a detriment to maybe what they want to do or what they want to develop. So in all due fairness to the school, that's why we even started talking about this to begin with, was whatever we could do to make it better for the school district. So that's why I'd like to see it get to stay there.
Just a quick question. You mentioned two numbers, $100,000 maybe next year, rough estimate, and then you throw out a $30 million number. Where exactly is that number coming from, and why do you think that?
How long have you been in town, Kurt?
I've been in 7 years.
Okay. I probably happened before you were there. If you know the main administration building, they've got a gazebo out there, and they took down three parts of that building. They called them, I think, D, E, and F. Could be wrong. Could be C, D, and E, or whatever. But they called them, they had alphabet numbers. On the north side of the building are similar ones called J, K, and L. If I recall, and I could stand corrected, it was about $3.5 to $4 million to take that part down. It's asbestos abatement, things like that. And that was probably 10, 12 years ago. And that was the state doing it themselves without going out for bid or anything like that. So we've got at least that much on the north side of that building, and maybe two other, maybe three other buildings, and I don't know what we're gonna do with the dietary building, the boiler, and the smokestack. So that's worst case scenario, I think. But if you cut it in half, it's still pretty big chunk to that's the best I can answer that for you. The 100,000 is just maintenance of what we have there, and even if it's 50,000 and we don't have the boiler on all the time, that's still a big chunk without something in writing. And I would like to see our state representative here and our state senator here. I don't care about emails. I'd like to see him here and tell us what they're going to do for us. Jim Matheson was a senator. He'd come up here all the time. In fact, he couldn't turn around without running into Jim Matheson. He lived in Sedalia. Tom Marshall was here. We had good representation there. I haven't seen Dean Dorman at all. I'd like to have them make a call, special meeting, and invite them, the Office of Administration, the Department of Resources, and anybody who might have anything to do with the funding, have them come here and tell how the situation works, and if they think our deadline of April 5th is a reasonable deadline or not. That's all I'm asking. And I'd appreciate feedback either way on it. And I hope that the rest of the council members would too. And the other thing I wanted to do is keep things as open as possible, let everybody know what's going on. Charlie?
Is that April date you're talking about there, is that a hard and fast date that they...
I haven't heard anything about that.
Connie?
Yeah, that's what they told me today, yes.
Is that negotiable?
Well, we've been negotiating with them for months. That's how, I mean, we've changed the date, I don't know how many different times. I'm sure it probably would be if it got right down to it, but I don't know that though, because what they told me today was they would give us until April the 5th, and then they would have to move forward to give it, to put it out for bid to somebody else, to